Good afternoon and welcome back to Asgaard. So today I wanted to do a quick tutorial video. I'd had a request early in my Sky Factory video. I'd tried to set up a ore system using compacting drawers. By the way, these are my slave pigs. But anyway, I tried to set up a ore processing system with compacting drawers, and it didn't work out because the pack didn't support it at the time. However, since then, the pack has been updated to support it. So I had a request just wanting to see how I was going to set that up. So I'll really quickly go over that. Now, granted, it's, you know, there's better ways to set up the system, like what I ended up doing in Sky Factory. But for some reason, I've always liked the compacting drawer setup. Just because I like the way it looks and everything, especially for early setups. So we'll really quickly cover that. So the first thing you're going to want is, of course, the drawer controller, and hook up your drawers. You can use trim or you can use just drawers or whatever. Basically, that's going to connect to your output. So all the items that we can send out will go to here. Now, temporarily, however, I'm probably going to disable this for right now. The reason being is because if we don't, it's just going to dump all of our items into there. So you want to manage everything, as you add it in, because otherwise you're going to end up with, you know, all your broken tin pieces and broken copper and all that just going wherever it wants to. So until you get the system fully set up, I suggest not, leaving empty drawers anywhere. So, of course, the first thing that we're going to want to set up is just our cobble gen. So we'll just really, really quickly set that up, because I don't want to spend a whole lot of time on that because we've covered that before. So I think we're going to set it up. We'll just set it up right here. Doesn't really, really matter. Because you can compact, whenever I build stuff, you can always compact it down. It's just I kind of spread it out just for you guys to see. And we'll go ahead and just throw a bunch of world interaction upgrades in there. And then the next thing we're going to need is, of course, some way to smash this down. I think we're just going to go with, we'll go with Ender IO's sag mill, I think, is how we're going to do it. So we'll run our cobblestone, whoops, there. We'll just run that over to here. Configure this to, well, it doesn't really matter. It's going to input to the top anyway. And we'll just hook power into this. So I've just got creative capacitor banks. You know, you can just use whatever on that. And so this is going to start breaking down and getting sand and, oh, it does sand as the primary in this pack. So let's change that over really, really quick to, say, a pulverizer. Sometimes it does sand as the primary, and sometimes it does gravel as the primary, so I can never recall, you know, which it does. Input, and we'll say output out the side there. So we've got gravel and with a secondary of sand coming through. So what we're going to do is we'll set up our sieves here. And of course, you could expand on this like I did in my series and say you got your pulverizer here and then do like a sag mill here making sand, and then do a sag mill to a pulverizer for your dust. And you could do that. I'm just going to do it with a single setup to show you how this works. But you could expand on this and have the multi creation setup. And then we'll have our, we'll just set up our sieve right there for right now. And let's get, you can use item conduits, you could use transfer nodes, just any way of moving your items over to this. And let's put our capacitor bank here so this has power. So this is going to start smashing up the gravel. And then what we're going to do with that is, let's give it just a second to smash its first piece of gravel. Actually, let's put speed upgrades, and we'll throw some fortune upgrades in there too. And so now we're producing all this assorted junk. And what we're going to do is, let's grab, like, we'll grab these byproducts like flint, lapis, and we'll just throw these into some drawers here. No. And I'm going to break these so they're not connected for right now. That way we can connect up our system here. And so what we're going to do is we're going to have the items from this come out. We'll just set up a transfer node and we'll just run the items over to our controller. So now you'll notice that all of the flint and coal should be getting pulled out. Well, it's not going to because I forgot. These are going to stop up the system. Well, we'll leave it like that because once we get this set up, it won't matter. Now, you could do item conduits, and that would keep it from stopping up the system because, of course, item conduits are only going to pull out items that it can actually put somewhere. And we'll throw in... Let me break off some of these here. And we will throw in, like, Sirtis here. Anyway, so we'll have the miscellaneous items go into those drawers. And then the other items, we're going to have them come over to some compacting drawers. And we'll just set these up. For right now, we'll just set them up right here. And you're going to need, if I recall, it's like 10, I believe, to cover all the different ores that are added. And let's really, really quickly, let's just grab these different ores here. And you're going to put ores into each compacting drawer. So you've got a drawer for each ore. And let's see, that one's new. Okay. And then what we'll do is we'll just, let me break these for now. And we'll hook these up to our system. So now this is all linked up. Now I do believe iron maybe is one of the ones that's not, doesn't have a place yet. Yeah. So we'll put that down and our compacting drawer and give it iron. And let's grab some, really, really quickly, let's grab some speed upgrades for this so that it moves a little bit faster. And throw that in there. So now it should move through the items a bit faster. We're getting crushed. Oh yeah, because I haven't filtered this for sand specifically. What you'd want to do is, if you want to filter this, have it set to extract only the primary from the side and say the secondary maybe through the bottom. And what you could do is you could set up another sieve here. And usually what I'll do is I'll link this up. So we've got, let me see here. Let me hook that onto there. And let me grab a wrench really, really fast. Okay. And we'll just bring this over and that. So now all the sand will come through here by default instead of going into here. Now, it's not really an issue, honestly, if these items get mixed up. That's not really a problem. But, you know, I just like having it all sorted a little bit better than that. And that I actually don't want going in there. Anyway, so back to these ores. Let me just dump out like the crushed because we don't really want that in here. Cocoa beans, we don't want in here. And we'll hook that up there. And let me actually give this some speed upgrades as well. Because otherwise, this way it's a little bit quicker. It's, yeah, right here, item speed. Okay. Alright, sorry about that. So we've got all of our ores coming in here to get compacted. And what we're going to want to do is let's go ahead and lock all of these. And you want to make sure and lock them because I've in the past I've not locked them and things get crazy, because what happens is it wants to just pull all the ores out, and then it'll empty it out, and then it'll start dumping ores wherever, and you end up with a bunch of fragments of different ores all over the place. So it's just, it's much better to just go ahead and lock it. And then what we're going to want to do is let's grab a piece of each of these completed gravels, and we're going to set up a filter for this, because you don't want it pulling out the fragments. You only want it pulling out the completed ores. So we would come through and we would do this for each of these. So there's iron, and put that on there, and then tin. And I'm just going to end there, because you pretty much do this for all the ores. But otherwise, we're going to end up spending a while setting those up. So, why is this is not pulling out right now? Oh, because cobblestone got in there somehow. Okay, that's fixed. So you've got your ores being compacted into, the gravels, the broken pieces into the gravels, and you're only extracting the completed gravel. And then what you would do is you would take these ores out, and you would just run, normally you'd just have your transfer pipes, but we're not going to connect them right here, because otherwise it's going to want to actually connect them into those drawers. But we'll run this over to say like right here, I guess. And what we're going to do is we're going to pump these into a hammer. And you'll see that our gravels are starting to come in. And then we would just set up a capacitor bank, or, hook your energy in. And it's going to start running through that. Now we'll throw some speed upgrades in there because we want it to be quicker. And then what you would do is you would, once this is done, once these items are completed, you would just set up a drawer controller. Not a drawer controller, sorry. Did I throw it away? I think I did. But you want a slave. So let's get a controller slave. And the way these work is they're pretty much a drawer controller. As in, they can import and export from the system. And they hook in, the same way and everything. However, they don't expand the length. Of course, these drawer controllers, I think, is like 20, I want to say 25 blocks in each direction that they can manage, with a linked up system. The controller slave doesn't expand that distance. It just, within that distance, it allows you another place to import and export items into and out of the system. So, over here, we've got something. Platinum is backing it up. So let's throw down a compacting drawer. And we'll lock that one in. Now there should be like one more, I want to say, ore. But anyway, so we've got the stuff running through and it's creating these crushed ores. Now what we could do is, before we hook all that in, let's set up another line of controllers. We'll just set them up. Not controllers, I'm sorry. Compacting drawers, and we'll set them up like right here. And so now all of the ores that we get, which actually I'm only going to set up three. You would do 10, but because we're only actually running like three different ores right now, you're going to, of course, throw these into your compacting drawers like before you plug this in. If you have all the items that are coming from this already being sorted, you don't have to worry about that, because the items are only going to go into these slots as long as there's space, so you won't have to worry about them trying to fill up these compacting drawers. And we're just going to hook this up with trim, And then what we're going to do is just bring our items out. So transfer node connects right to here. And these will start getting pumped out. And let's grab some speed upgrades here, so that this will work a little bit faster. And so these are getting pumped out and they're getting dumped into here. If you notice, we have 25 aluminum ore sand, 54 iron, and 14, sorry, 10. So, you know, that's all working as intended. And then what we would do is we would do the same thing as we did last time. We would grab some of this and set up filters. So in this case, we want this. Set up that and our filter. And then, oops, iron, we would set up right back here. And then, tin. So now we've got all of those extracting. And then we would set up pretty much the exact same system over here. We would set up a hammer, give it some power, and then we're just going to pump the items in and just go up like that. And there we go. So we've got our ores coming in. Now let's grab speed upgrades and give that to that. And then one last time, let's repeat the system. So compacting drawers, we're only going to do three of them for this. And let's grab like our powdered iron ore, plug it in, and we should be able to just link this up, because I think this should be okay. And make sure, by the way, and lock these. I forgot to lock those. And I think it's going to keep running through iron for quite a while. But anyway, once it gets to this point, what you're going to do is just set up your filter again. Setting up the filters is my least favorite part, by the way. I hate doing it. Now, granted, keep in mind that you don't have to use transfer nodes for this. Any kind of filterable item conduit will work. So, you know, if you're at the point where you can use item conduits, you're more than welcome to do those with filters. That's not a problem at all. What you can do if you have item conduits is just set an insert to, like, for example, I'll actually do item conduits right here to show you how you could do that. What you could do is you could just get yourself one item filter per line. Now, actually, I think you'd need an advanced item filter, because you're going to need you're going to need 10 slots, and I think the advanced item filter has 10. So let's actually grab one of those. Or you could do multiple basic item filters. And I'll show you both ways that you could set that up. No, I don't want filters, I want conduits. And what you could do is you could set this up, extract always active, and give it, or you wouldn't have to give it a filter. And then what you would do is, let me grab, we're going to be pumping all of this directly into a pulverizer to double it, or a sag mill would work too, which we've actually got one right here. Okay, and let's get a octatic capacitor. Okay, so what you could do is you could set up your sag mill, and then your item conduits, where they plug in, you could just set a filter here. And say we want to do, these are not going. you know why they're not going, because I didn't set up the thing. My bad. By the way, right here, you can actually use the same controller slave here. You don't have to make a new one. So we're going to just connect this transfer node up right there. And let's get some speed upgrades really, really quick to make that a bit faster. And that's going to start filling up this system here with our items. I totally forgot to have the items actually being pumped out of the hammer. So make sure and do that, and of course make sure and lock those. Now, what we could do is with our item conduits, let's go ahead and set up these as well. Extract always active. And on the insert, let's tell it that it can only accept these items. Now, like I said, you could use an advanced item filter. It has 10 slots, so you would be able to hold all 10 ores that are present in Sky Factory 2.5. However, if you're not to that point, because they do take a little bit more than basic item filters, what you could do is you could set up separate lines here and say, like, this one has your first, you know, so many ores, and then this one over here has your other set. I believe 10 is the one. Okay. And you could also do this with a chest as well. Usually what I would do is I would put like a buffer chest, say on top of this, and set it to, you know, push pull from here, and just have the item conduits hooked up into that. So that's an option as well, if you want to do that. And what we would do is we would just bring our item conduits over. They would start extracting and cooking up your aluminum or breaking up your aluminum and everything. And then what we would do is we would just pull from here and then pull it to, say, an alloy smelter. And we'd set up our alloy smelter, say, right here. Our capacitor bank, octatic capacitor, and there we go. So it's now cooking up the aluminum, and then once it's done with that, we would just have it extract from here. And I know this is a mess, but you know, it's pretty much, I forgot to set this to push, I had it on pull, there we go. And then what we could do is we could just run our items out of this. Oops. And say, let's run them over here. And you could set up another controller. You know, you're not limited to the number of controller slaves that you have, so you could have set up another one over there. I'm just kind of running it across. But you could do it however you so desire as far as that goes. And then you just link this in, and what it's going to do is it's going to pump the items whenever it can to this controller slave. And so what you would do is, let's just set up some more drawers here. And you'll see that now we have aluminum funneling into the system. And as this gets stuff, you know, done, it's going to come over to these storage drawers. Now, you could also, of course, plug this system into your AE system or whatnot. And as long as you have this set up to accept these items on the compacting drawer, that's going to take precedence. So if you have your items ran through and say you're using item conduits, you set the priority to the controller as the highest priority, and then have, say, your AE system as the secondary priority, all the ore fragments that it can accept are going to come into this first. You're not going to have to worry about your ore fragments going into the AE system unless these drawers fill up. Now, if that's a concern of yours, you can always set a filter onto it to, say, only allow diamond, sardis, emerald, and et cetera, into your AE system. But as long as you have that drawer controller as the highest priority and only have slots for these items, so if we didn't have any of these drawers back here, it would go into here and then into your AE system or whatever. anything that's left over. So, and then of course you could just hook your alloy smelter up to the AE system and everything would be, you know, working good and everything. Now keep in mind, like I said, you can expand on this and have, a setup for, say, sand that, you know, would send the, I wonder why that's not... Maybe because this doesn't have power, I bet. No? That's not why. I have no clue why the sand's like... No, we're not going to go... Oh, I see why. I see the issue right here. You could... There we go. You could have the sand system plugged into here and do the exact same method, except, you know, instead of it dropping its fragments into there, it would start here. And you wouldn't have to worry about it because all the crushed aluminum, crushed sand, crushed iron and stuff is going to go here. All the powdered is going to go here and so on. So that's pretty much the setup. If you guys have any questions, feel free to let me know. I hope I covered it in depth and everything enough so that you guys can set it up in your worlds if you're interested in doing so. Like I said, this is just an alternative to the system that I ended up using in Sky Factory, but I know when I first went through Sky Factory, this wouldn't work because the compacting drawers, for some reason, didn't want to compact the ore fragments. So, as always, though, if you guys have any questions or anything, feel free to let me know. And if you guys have any other questions, even outside of this, feel free to let me know, and I will do the best I can to help you guys out as quickly as I can. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, as always, please comment, like, subscribe. It's very, very much appreciated. And until next episode, do take care, and I hope to see you guys then.